Our sister, being the oldest in the family, abused us the whole time we were kids. And I have some of the scars still remaining. And
John, I do too. Yeah. I have bruises here.
We have scars because of the times that she chased us to do the dishes or whatever. And so we wanted to let people know that it hasn't all been peaches and cream. To start off, we want to wish you a happy 85th birthday. Because I didn't think you were going to make it.
I was lucky enough to go to Yale in Connecticut, and Mom and Dad came out to visit one Parents' Weekend, I think it was, as when I was a sophomore.
Yeah, he was telling everybody what a good bridge player I was.
And I mentioned she was coming and that she was really much better than I was and that we would have fun. She could give us more pointers.
I said, well, what if I don't get the card, you know?
And we played bridge as college students want to do in a marathon binge fashion.
I did get the cards and everything was working fine.
She had one fantastic hand after another, so not only did we learn the pointers, but she basically won every game.
And I quit right then and there. I didn't go back.
Even since she had her two strokes, I've heard from people who are playing bridge from her that it hasn't affected her at all, that she's still a great bridge player.
Oh yeah. I still can play bridge. The good Lord didn't take away that ability.
Her volunteer work has involved young children right at the grade school across the street here. And when she taught full-time, it was high school, but I know she just loved it.
One of the things that Mom got involved in that remains today that is really meaningful is it's a social service agency in Monmouth. It's a ministry called Jamison Center, and she was on the founding board of that. They saw a need. There really were no social service agencies in Monmouth.
I took charge of the programs for Jamison Center. It became Jamison Center. And I was a volunteer director down there for a couple years.
There was some resistance to founding Jamison Center. And she told me just a year or so ago that she came home once and said, you know, I'm just gonna give up. And my dad said, you can't do that. You know, this is important work. You gotta cry it out and get up tomorrow and go and do it again.
Her whole life has been devoted to other people. In a way that's really, I'm obviously a little biased, but it's really quite impressive and admirable, and I'm very proud of her. She's a great lady. She was a teacher for many years professionally, but she's a natural teacher as well and has always been always was a great teacher for us kids.
And all of us had her as a teacher in class, which was sometimes a little tense.
Skipping school, for example, was a pretty difficult thing to do because your mom knew whether or not you were truly sick or whatever. They could go down the hall and ask her if she actually wrote that note. So it kind of eliminated a lot of that thing right off the top.
She'd bend over backwards to be sure that she wasn't showing any partiality to her own children. So we had to toe the line.
I tried not to be, but I may have been a little tough on them.
Her class was my only afternoon class. So whenever she was sick and we had a substitute, I'd skip out of school early. We'd tell the teacher that we had to go put out the wrestling mats. I got caught too, and that didn't go over well. It's a downside to having your mother as a teacher. Can't get away with anything.
I was a little bit of a chatter in her class, and I can remember her sitting at home averaging the grades, and she would say, darn it, you got an A again. because I think she was really hoping at some point my chatter was going to interfere with my performance in class.
They were all good students. Well, I was teaching in the school, and so they had to be. Well, I didn't intend to be a teacher when I went to school. I was going to be a scientist and work in a lab and stuff, but I met Phil.
Right. How about our wedding? Oh, God, the wedding. I was into photography. And Mother Orpha said, Charles, we want you to take pictures of the whole wedding. But come wedding day, we were obsessed with trying to tie cans and stuff in the back of her car. And that's what I did. And in the process thereof, I forgot to take pictures of the wedding.
There was a period of time when my parents were divorced. Briefly, when I was in college, they divorced maybe only for a couple years, and then they remarried, and I was the best man in my parents' wedding. So I always thought that was kind of cool.
One of my favorite memories is they had decided to get back together, and you know, now we know that it was, you know, forever from that point. But Mom had already planned to go to Europe with Ron and with my grandpa, and they were coming back, and he decided, let's just, you know, find somebody else to run the store and go up and meet their plane and surprise them. And I can still remember my mom's face. She just dropped her purse right in the airport. I mean, I picked it up for her because it was such a great surprise. And you know, just for me, after everything we'd all been through, it was a really neat day.
Phyllis, we have to admit, you were a pretty good sister. And I hate to say this, we love you a lot, and we wish you the best. And we're so happy to be back here to celebrate this
weekend. I love you, sis. When we lost our first child, Mark, she was there for us, and I was really devastated by that. But she was there as a good friend and sister, and I loved her for that, and it was a real help to hear her compassion.
It's like, okay, so you can't do this, but what can you do? And let's find a way, and it always needs to be focused on what she can do to help other people.
When I became a born-again Christian, it was because I knew all that stuff. It had happened 20 years prior, and it was because she insisted that we go to church.
Unconditional love. She's always been there for me, and I know she always will be. And really, there's almost no one in the world that you can say that about. But you can say it about her, and I can say it about her.
Happy birthday, Mom. We all love you.
Happy birthday, Mom. You're the best.
Happy 85th birthday, Mom, and many more.
Well, let's give her a quick happy birthday song.
All right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Phyllis. Happy birthday to you.